They believe their partner is responsible for their happiness. And the fact is that serial cheaters are often putting all the responsibility on other people for their happiness, and they don't take the time to investigate what they do within themselves, and they certainly don't give their spouse the time to work on it. I think it's really frustrating to talk to couples all the time who they just went out and started taking these actions, cheating, or having emotional entanglement with people on the job because they felt unhappy. And they blame their unhappiness on their spouse because everything was great before I was married. I remember when. And you've forgotten that your happiness comes from within.
That's
like,
right.
I can never make you happy. You need to be happy and whole within yourself. Your spouse's responsibility is not to make you happy.
Absolutely. And the reality is, listen, if you haven't found happiness within yourself, then there's nothing that your spouse can do to ever fill that void. Mm-hmm. And that's what happens. Well, since you can't do it, I'm going to go out and find somebody else who'll do it. But then, once again, it's temporary, right? It's that feeling of newness, that feeling of excitement, and then it's short-lived, and then you're off to the next and off to the next. So it's like emptiness within you that can't be filled because there's a hole within that individual.
And I think that person probably, if they actually had some good counseling, someone to sit them down, they would find in their lives, they're always going from one need to the next. Like, they have this insatiable desire for happiness. They've been turning every rock, trying everything, and they've yet to find
it.
But there's been nothing inside them that says, okay, this isn't the way, this isn't working. They're still searching and seeking outside of their relationship.
Let's go to the next point. They feel entirely misunderstood. We hear this oftentimes that, you know what, you just don't get me. You just don't understand me. Like, we just don't connect. And the reality is, the person who feels misunderstood oftentimes can be guilty of bottling in what's going on the inside of them. Like, we would say that overwhelmingly, a large majority of people wind up in affairs because they couldn't feel comfortable having a conversation with their spouse about what was really going on the inside, what they were thinking, what they were feeling. And so rather than becoming vulnerable, they shut down and reconnected with someone else who they had a surface relationship with because they fear vulnerability. They fear becoming emotionally naked. They have no problem becoming physically naked. That's easy.
Yeah.
That's what people do on a regular. But to open up my heart and open up my mind, I don't think that I'm ready for that. And so as a result, you give your spouse a false impression. They may be thinking everything's all right, but yet and still you're bubbling on the inside. Something's going on wrong on the inside. And you never took the time to articulate it to your partner. So they are oblivious. They're clueless. They don't know. And then that's when they're shocked about this affair. They're like, well, where did this all come from?
So true.
And then you open up and talk about what was wrong. And they're saying, well, why didn't you tell me that months ago, years ago? I'm thinking we're living two different lives. Remember, we talk about
two different realities
on the same journey together, but two very different experiences. So the person who feels misunderstood is because they've contributed to that situation by not opening up and sharing.
Wow.